If you're tight on space and you need to do an Arduino project, you could do one here on an ATtiny84. It's a little bit bigger than the ATtiny85 that I showed you a few months ago, and we're going to do that right here, right now. I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. A little while ago, we did a video on the ATtiny85. Now we're going to do one on 84 because it has a lot more inputs and outputs, and it's a lot bigger. I got this from DigiKeys for $2.04 per unit. It's the ATtiny84 20PU. Now they do have ATtiny84As that are $1.19. I haven't tried those out, but I have these. I ordered these about 3 months ago and haven't even opened it up yet. So let's just open this thing up here. So it's a 14-pin IC, and we'll put this on the board and let you see what it's like. If you still need some extra space and want to program this, it's easily programmed from your Arduino. You could use an Arduino Uno. I'm going to show you how to do it on an Arduino Uno, but you could also do it on a Nano and a Pro Mini. It doesn't matter which one you use, but we're going to do it on that. If you remember on the If you remember on the ATtiny85, we used this thing here. You can't use this on there because it's only set up for an 8-pin integrated circuit. But you'll notice this little chip right here, this little SMD chip right here, this is an ATtiny84 on there. So it's using an ATtiny84 to program the ATtiny85. But if you would like to see more videos like this and learn about electronics, Arduino, and model railroading, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And while you're at it, ding that bell so you could be notified whenever I have a new video coming out. And now they have Premiere. So every once in a while, I'm going to put on one on Premiere, so we have a chat window on the side and you could watch it together when it comes out. And check out my playlist where you could find a lot of videos categorized for you to find easily. So let's get started with this right now. Here I have it set up on the breadboard, and all it takes is 6 wires going to the Uno. You have the plus and the minus, and then you have 10, 11, 12, and 13 on the Uno going to pins 4, 7, 8, and 9. And I'll show you how to set this up again as an ISP. And as you can see here, here's your high low tech org page, and you just come down here, and that's what you do. You copy this right here and put that into your board manager, additional board managers like that. You'll be able to upload to an ATtiny. First thing we have to do is make our Arduino Uno an ISP, so we'll have to bring up a sketch for that, and that can be found right here in the examples. Right there, Arduino ISP. And what we'll do is we'll have to set up our Arduino on here so we can use it as an ISP. All we do to get started with this is just make sure that you don't have your power leads on the breadboard. I have everything all hooked up, except that I disconnected the power leads on there. And what we're going to do now is go over to this sketch right here for ISP, and we have board Arduino Uno, which we're using on here, and we're on COM port 3 and programming, and we have Arduino as ISP. So what we'll do right here is we'll upload this sketch, Arduino ISP, to the Arduino right here. And as it's doing this, it's compiling right now. And now it's uploading, and it's finished uploading. Now we could put a program from a sketch onto here, and we'll do that right now. I added a 10 microfarad capacitor to this one here. Long time ago, they added a 10 microfarad capacitor to all the sketches when they were programming the ATtiny85. And when I did it, I didn't add the capacitor to it because the instructions they gave on the 85 were old, and they were on older versions of the Arduino IDE. Now, I just pulled up one instruction that had it for the version of Arduino that I have, and it showed a capacitor in there. So I'm going to try it with the capacitor. If you do decide to use the capacitor, make sure that you put it between the reset and the ground. The ground goes to the negative. If it is, when you put the electrolytic capacitor in there, you'll see that it has a band on it that it's clearly marked as the negative. The negative goes on the ground. If you reverse the polarity on this and put it in the wrong way, you have a chance of either blowing this thing up, it'll go whoosh, or your Arduino will burn up. Arduinos are set to shut down at 40 milliamps, so the best thing that might happen is that it would shut down, but the worst case scenario is this thing will explode. It's metal and it can hurt you, so beware. When I did the smaller version of it, the ATtiny85, I didn't use the capacitor and it still worked. But here's how it's set up. We got the four pins on there to program it. I got the power on it, got the capacitor on it. Now I have this sketch right here. What it's gonna do is it's gonna turn on LEDs on all the pins. I'm not gonna go into showing you a program on it. You could put your own programs into it. I'm gonna set this up later and show it to you with all the LEDs hooked up to it. But I'm just gonna show you right now that I'm going to put this program into it. It will light up 11 LEDs. I modified this from somebody else's sketch. They had different pin numbers on there, and I don't know why they had the pin numbers on there backwards, but I changed a few things on it so it'll work on here. First thing we have to do to program on the ATtiny is to identify it on here. And we do it this way, the same way we did with the Uno. We just come down here and go down to the bottom, ATtiny84. If you don't see the ATtiny84 and 85 board on your menu, then you'll have to go back to the highlow.org page and redo the instructions that I showed you how to put that into your board manager. Once you do that, shut down your Arduino IDE and start it back up, and you should be able to see it then. Come down here, processing. It's already on ATtiny84. 1 megahertz, that's what the default is on there. It's on COM port 3 and programmer on the ISP. So now we're ready to upload it to the ATtiny. Okay, according to this right here, that's telling me that everything worked out okay and it uploaded all right. I have 9 of the 11 outputs hooked up. It was a little bit too far to get the last two in there on here. I have 470 ohm SIP resistors on here. And I have 4 on this side and 5 on this side here. So let's turn this thing on and see what happens. All 9 of them light up for a half a second and go off, and then the next one. They go all in sequence. And that's what we programmed into this ATtiny84. Now you could program anything into it that you would like. It doesn't have to be LEDs. You just have to make sure that when you program something in there that uses up more power than this, you have to use a separate power supply. You power this with the number 1 and number 14 pins on here. As you can see on this pinout for the ATtiny84, the pins on the IC 1 through 14 do not correspond with the pins for your Arduino sketch. So if you want to use pin 2 for an output on there, you would identify it in your sketch as pin 10, and so on down the line. Pin 7 would be pin 6. Pin 13 on your ATtiny would be pin 0 in your sketch. So you have to keep that in mind when you're writing your sketch. That's it for now on the ATtiny. I hope you enjoyed it and learned something from this video. We got some more videos coming out. I got a project I'm working on here. I've been working on this for a while. This part is finished. I have to do the rest of it on there. And we got another project on the DCC++ coming up pretty soon. I'm going to give you some more tips on this. And I'm going to show you how to use it with a Raspberry Pi. So you could even eliminate the computer, so all you have right here is this and a power supply to operate. So that's all it's going to take. So look for that in the near future. And until then, we'll see you.